is the south side, is East LA. And there's 150,000 farm workers who are poisoned by pesticides every year. And God knows what's happening to their children, because they bring those chemicals home to their families and it exposed that to their children. And the government has done no studies, there's been no research, there's been no steps taken to protect the families of farm workers from the ravages of pesticide poisoning that we know and you know and everybody knows they're experiencing on a daily basis. And that's because, you know, there's nothing wrong with having business people in government. It's a great idea if your objective is to recruit competence and expertise. But in all of these situations, these individuals have entered government service not to serve the public interest, but rather to subvert the very laws that they're now charged with enforcing in order to enrich this president's corporate paymasters, to make the rich richer, to increase the concentration of wealth at the top, and to turn the poor into commodities that serve them, and to turn this country into a kind of feudalism. And that's what Barack Obama is fighting against, to return this nation to its status as an exemplary nation, as the example to all the rest of the world of democracy and justice, which has always been our historical mission. I'm going to tell you one last story. When I was a little boy, my father took me to Europe, and we went to Czechoslovakia, and to Poland, and to France, and England, and Greece, and Germany, and everywhere we went, we were met by vast crowds of people, hundreds of thousands of people, who came out onto the street because they wanted to be near an American politician, because they loved our country. They were hungry for our moral authority. They were starved for our leadership from the United States. They proudly named their streets after our presidents, Washington, Jefferson, Lincoln, Roosevelt, and Kennedy. And I remember the day after 9/11, when the headline on the biggest newspaper in France was, Lamont, we are all Americans now. We were the most beloved nation on the face of the earth. For 3 weeks after 9/11, Muslim people in Tehran, by the tens of thousands, came out onto the streets and lit candles. In solidarity, have candlelight vigils to express their love, their solidarity, their sympathy for the United States of America. We were the most beloved nation on the face of the earth. And it took 230 years of visionary, restrained, and disciplined leadership to make our nation the most loved nation on the planet. And in 7 short years, through monumental arrogance and incompetence, these people in the White House have drained those reservoirs dry. And today, the United States is the most feared nation on the face of the earth. Because I saw in the faces of those crowds, hundreds of thousands of people when I was a little boy, the hope for leadership from the United States of America. Not just to do good things for our country, but to do great things for all of humanity. And you know, Abraham Lincoln said that America is a great nation because we are a good nation. And if we stop being a good nation, we will quickly lose our greatness as well. Well, we are doing things today in this country that none of us ever imagined Americans would ever do. We are torturing people in this country. Americans are torturing people. We're eavesdropping on our own citizens. I had John Dean on my radio show the other day. And you remember who John Dean was? He was the lawyer for President Nixon. And after President Nixon was impeached, resigned, Dean went to jail for 4 months. And get strategic information from. And at that time, Washington troops were barefoot. We were losing the war badly. We were about to lose our country. The British were torturing our soldiers in New York Harbor on coffin ships, prison ships, and killing them by the dozens every day. But Washington said, no, we will not torture people. He said, this is the first nation on the face of the earth that is based on an idea. And the idea is one of humanity and justice and democracy. And if we start engaging in that behavior, we will lose our soul as a people. And I will not do it. Dream.